Hey, Benny Fish. It is the 15th of July, 2018. And quite honestly, I mean, I got like 20 videos I would just love to share with you, you know? Well, the worldly responsibilities, I mean, this is busy time of year, but every time I sit down and just look for a couple of minutes, I see things that are just illustrating and telegraphing and just showing this satanic new world being creature just emerging, you know, and showing how God's working to bring his people out of this mess, right? And so I just jumped on this one this morning because it's just crazy, okay? They're talking about luxury camping, okay? This particular article's in New York City, the Stricken family, right? And they go through how it's becoming so trendy and everything to do this. And all I'm seeing really is people just seeking out pleasures in their life to fulfill the emptiness in their lives because they're so busy and being successful and all these things, right? So they try to escape and like, it's a vacation means reconnecting with nature for the Stricken family, not with God. No. And there's a little video that accompanies this article, right? And they show all these tents. Now, does that remind you of anything right there? I mean, I'm sorry, but the first thing that popped into my head was this, the creepy Denver airport, which I don't know the connection there, but that's what popped into my mind. So I'm watching this little video that goes along with this, and of course, there's the Statue of Liberty. You get to look out of your little tent, and this is the family that they talk about, you know what I mean? This is the article target family, and of course, it's a fatherless family of these three girls, and, you know, I'm not even going to go there, but nonetheless, they're just seeking this fulfillment in something that's never going to fulfill them because, you know, it's a reconnecting with nature, not with God, no, with nature. But the Stricken family, that name just struck me weird, okay? So I just pop it in real easy. Stricken, it's a well-known name out of Scotland, English, Norse, Old Norse origins, and this is their family crest. And I look at this and I'm like, three scallop shells on black, and I noticed that the scalloping on the shells have six scallops on each one. So it's essentially a 666, right? And you could put in the 333, a 999. You see what I'm saying? It's got a very interesting pattern to this little crest of theirs, their coat of arms. So I look up Stricken just because that's how it hit me, is two words, right? And there is such a thing as a strick. And apparently, it's a flat piece of wood used for leveling off grain in a measure, a bushel. So, for measuring out grain, right? So when you use this tool to do the measuring off of the grain, it's been stricken. And so I look up stricken, and it's afflicted or overwhelmed by, or as if by disease, misfortune, or sorrow, made incapable or unfit. Sounds to me exactly like the United States, a strict land. I'm sorry, you guys. This is just the way I see it, okay? Hit or wounded by or as if by a missile. Why would they put that in there is beyond me, but there it is, okay? This is what I get. Can't help it. Really, I can't. The Stricken family, okay? And then I'm looking at this little video they do, and in several spots, it's pretty interesting. And I want to show you exactly what Governor's Island is, okay? So let me skip around here a little bit because it's like 5 minutes long. And there's all kinds of weirdness in it, but there's two particular places that I just want to share with you. Right here, this guy's talking with this trendy girl, all in her purple and scarlet and all that rigmarole, and look where they decide to interview them, okay? It just happens to be right in front of the Washington Arch, okay? And then watch where it segues immediately from here into. This is just interesting stuff. Yada, yada, yada. Yes, it's very trendy. It's very fun. I'm sorry, but it's just all worldly ridiculousness. There goes the Washington Arch, and the very next scene, they're on Governor's Island. There's your tent, and there's your arch, and they're facing west. And the Statue of Liberty is literally, like, right over here. It's just out of this picture, okay? Or, actually, yeah, it's right over there, and I'm going to show you right now where this is. This is crazy. All right, we go to New York on good old Google Earth. Don't be evil. Let me make this proper here so it's fit. There we go. All right. Now here's Governor's Island right here. Sorry for my... But this is just... Satan is busted. He is exposed. And what do we find on Governor's Island? Right where these people are camping, mind you. More or less in the belly of this little creature. This nice... friendly looking, like, whatever you want to call it, man. That's like mother of exile, mother of, like, the locust creatures right there. Do you see that? I hope you do. That is a spirit right there. And it's, if that isn't what you call manifest, then I don't know what is. And it sits right on Governor's Island, right where these people are camping, as they were looking through their arch, right over towards the Statue of Liberty. Right there. The real mother of exiles, right? And what's right above this creature's head? Directly above her head. A very ornate landscape architecture that just happens to be very similar to what the Statue of Liberty sits on, except this is a pentagram. She sits on an 11-pointed star. There is a absolute pentagram in this image right here, in this island. And I'm going to show you right there. It's not an accident, just like this creature is not an accident. I can never get over this stuff. You know where this reminds me of? Let's take a quick ride over to Chicago, because it's the same exact thing. It's displaying the same exact thing as they do here in Millennium Park in Chicago. There's your creature with the serpent to the serpent egg. You see where I'm coming from? It can also be an umbilical cord. This is their illustrating their birthing of their new creature. The New World Order. The One World Freedom Tower. Get a load of this. Right from this pentagram, right? These are just the things that come upon me to do to illustrate how Satan has been at work on this earth since the beginning, having men lay out his cities and spread his wickedness and basically serve him. I mean, that's what we all do. I mean, I'm not discluded from that, but I'm saved by the blood of Christ. There's the key to it all right there, quite literally. But right from this pentagram, and I mean exactly the way that it's pointing to the One World Freedom Tower. And the reason I go to that is because it's key. That event and what has come from it is like tells the whole story of Satan's plan here, man. These cube reflecting pools and whatnot, the Oculus serpent eye, and the upside down, right side up pyramid, One World Freedom Tower. Freedom. So I just draw a line. I'll just get to the point. Sorry. I draw a line to the Freedom Tower, right from Governor's Island, right to the Freedom Tower, right from the center of their landscape architecture here, right there, to the Freedom Tower. And I just find this really interesting, okay? Properties, we get the measurement, 1.51 miles, okay? You don't think much of that. We can look at it in yards and stuff. It happens to be 2,666 yards, but that's not all. I just want to show you this. I'm inclined to draw a line from that same exact center of that pentagram to the Statue of Liberty. Right there. Same exact center of the pentagram. Exactly to our loving Lady Liberty. Okay? Same thing. That's this line. Right here. And here's the properties of it. Exactly. 1.51 miles. Same gig. 2666. We could get into all the other numbers, but it's not really necessary. It's just to show you. Lucifer laid this all out. The builder. The master builder, according to the Freemasons. Okay? This is just a plan that we're witnessing manifest. And certain things are going to come upon the earth when that pit is open, and it will be. And I can't really tell you exactly what that'll be. But when I see these things, I have to share them with you. The bottom line is, this one world, this satanic spirit, this is manifesting into the natural world. And if you're not saved by the blood of Christ, it will ensnare you and cast you into everlasting darkness. This is how my spirit understands it, and it's imperative that you seek the truth. The truth. Who is Jesus Christ? And that's all I can give you, and you need to go and look into these things for yourself. Please read a Bible. Please reference. This link to eSword is in every description box of my videos. Please get it. Use it. Learn the words and understand that you're in a spiritual war, but it's coming to reality, and you need to know the truth through Christ Jesus and the Word of God. Okay, so that is that. Let me see. There was another thing I wanted to share with you. Oh, I didn't show you this. The Strickland family, I showed you about all their name. Guess what? They're in Gematria. Strickland. Okay? Yeah, you guessed it. So, if that isn't a little bit of butter on the pancakes, I don't know what is. Praise God. He's showing all this stuff so that we understand where we are at in time. Okay? The war is on, folks. You gotta get in there and choose a side. Seriously, choose this day. Truth or the lie? So, peace and grace to y'all. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,